the sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as he walks into the room where people pray, where we hear praises, he hears faith. There is a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as he walks into the room where people pray.
Hi, I'm Sarah. Welcome to Willi Church Online. We're so glad that you've joined us today and we look forward to connecting with you.
Today's reading is from Luke chapter 13, verses 10 to 17. Jesus heals on the Sabbath. One Sabbath day, as Jesus was teaching in a synagogue, he saw a woman who had been crippled by an evil spirit. She had been bent double for 18 years and was unable to stand up straight. When Jesus saw her, he called her over and said, "Dear woman, you are healed of your sickness." Then he touched her, and instantly she could stand straight. How she praised God! But the leader in charge of the synagogue was indignant that Jesus had healed her on the Sabbath day. "There are 6 days of the week for working," he said to the crowd. "Come on those days to be healed, not on the Sabbath." But the Lord replied, "You hypocrites! Each of you works on the Sabbath day. Don't you untie your ox or your donkey from its stall on the Sabbath and lead it out for water? This dear woman, a daughter of Abraham, has been held in bondage by Satan for 18 years. Isn't it right that she be released, even on the Sabbath?" This shamed his enemies, but all the people rejoiced at the wonderful things he did. This is the word of the Lord.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Willi Church Online. Megan here from the ministry team, and really glad that you have joined us, whether you are an every week member of our Willi Church community or whether you're joining us for the first time today. We are glad that you are here gathering with us in this virtual format. Welcome along. If you are new or perhaps relatively new to our church community, we would love for you to head on over to our connect page on our website, willichurch.org.au/connect. And we would love to hear from you, where you're at, a little bit about you so that we can connect with you where you are today. As we continue in the life of our church and step into a new season as a church community, connect groups are our central place in our church where community is happening. So if you're not already in a connect group, I really want to invite you today to consider joining one of our connect groups. Our groups meet together on Zoom, and they meet Sunday at 11 a.m., two of our groups. We also have groups meeting Tuesday evening and Wednesday evening, and also a Sunday afternoon families group. We would love for you to connect in with one of our groups. All of our groups have recently again expressed that they have room in them for you, and that they would love to have new people join in. So if you've been thinking for a while that you might like to join in one of our online connect groups, really want to invite you to do that today and to take that step. You can get in touch with me or Tiff or Sarah on our ministry team. We would love to find a group that connects with where you are and it works for you. This morning, I'm going to be bringing our devotional on Luke chapter 13. It's verses 10 to 17. And it's this incredible story that Luke tells us how Jesus heals a woman who's been crippled for 18 years. And he heals her on the Sabbath day. And so we've had that scripture read to us by Sarah this morning. And imagine the scene. Everyone's eyes are on Jesus because he's in the temple and he's gotten up to teach, to teach the word of God to those who were gathered to listen on the Sabbath day. And there was this woman in the temple. She was probably very well known by anyone who was local to that area. And no one could really explain why, but for 18 years she'd been crippled. Her bones of her spine were likely fused together, and the scripture tells us that that there was this spirit that had bound her. And yet with one touch by Jesus, with one word of Jesus, she is healed. Can you imagine the restoration she would have experienced in being healed of that physical infirmity, and yet being brought into community again, being brought out of isolation again? Imagine the incredible life trajectory that she now had because of what Jesus did for her. He has changed her life, changed the direction of her life. And you know, Jesus does that with us. Jesus changes our lives. He restores us into community from isolation. And Jesus says to this woman, you are set free from your infirmity, and no doubt from her isolation from community, which would have been caused by her, her physical infirmity, would have caused huge isolation in first century culture from the realms of community life. And then comes the real stinger, because the synagogue leader there gets up and criticizes Jesus harshly for healing on the Sabbath day, the one day that was set aside in the Jewish world for rest, for ceasing work, which is what Sabbath means, to cease. And yet Jesus didn't cease his work of restoring on this day. In fact, he heals this woman, as we are told. And so Jesus comes back to this synagogue leader and all who were gathered and says, basically, you have a double standard. You're living a double standard because you're happy to untie the knot of an animal that needs to be led to water, to drink water on that Sabbath day, which was something even the strictest of Jews were allowed to do. But Jesus says, you're not going to heal this woman. There's more regard here, Jesus says, for the needs of an animal than the needs of a woman who has been crippled for 18 years, who the woman has actually in her physical restoration been untied from her infirmity. But of course, Luke wants to get this message across that what better day than the Sabbath day to restore this woman, to heal this woman. We know Jesus was attacked several times for his work that he did on the Sabbath day. And Jews believed, you know, unless it was absolutely going to be a life-saving thing for a person, that really they shouldn't be healed. They should do it before the Sabbath or after the Sabbath. And even praying for the sick, you know, was a bit of a debated one amongst the Jewish people. But Jesus says here, what is more important is restoring this woman from infirmity to community. And Jesus says to the Jews gathered there that day, you know, what is really important here is restoring this woman, not the keeping, the harsh keeping of religious law. You see, Jesus' agenda is relationship, not religion. Jesus' agenda is freedom and not infirmity and not isolation. So what about you today? What freedom has God brought about in your story of faith? What freedom is God bringing right now in this season? What is God doing to free you? And what testimony do you have of God freeing you through Jesus from isolation, from illness, from affliction, from something in the spiritual world that has afflicted you or something that you have suffered with? In our own family life, we have a testimony in the past year of God freeing one of our family members from an illness that actually has really afflicted. And without going into details, God, through huge amounts of prayer, has really restored something that was very much a broken in our family story. And so I just want to ask you today, what is your testimony, like the woman, of how God frees us through Jesus from infirmity and from isolation back into community? Or maybe like this synagogue leader, Jesus wants to invite you not to be focused on religion and rule keeping, but to be focused on the relationship that he wants to have with you. You see, this is what Jesus is wanting to do through his ministry, through his presence coming into the world as a man, and showing, exemplifying the character of God in who he is, because he wants to free us from the grips of the enemy. He wants to free us from darkness and isolation and lies. And he wants to bring us into community. He wants to bring us into relationship with him in a joyful expression of relationship. So this morning, let's be encouraged through this scripture from Luke 13, that Jesus sets us free from our afflictions, that Jesus is right now wanting to do a new thing in us, even in this unusual season of 2020, because Jesus sets us free from our past. He sets us free from affliction, darkness, and loneliness. And he comes to bring life, freedom, and healing. And the kingdom of God is a kingdom of flourishing, of wholeness, of joy, of grace. And that's the kingdom that Jesus came to bring about. Would you pray with me? Oh Lord Jesus, we thank you for this story. We thank you for your ministry to this woman. We praise you that in this story and by this story in your scriptures, we get a glimpse, Jesus, of your agenda. Of your agenda of bringing freedom, bringing healing, bringing your grace, your forgiveness, bringing a beautiful freedom in place of religion and law keeping. So Lord Jesus, this morning, by your Holy Spirit, would you impart and let settle in each of us what you wanted to speak today and help us carry that into our week and into our future. And we just praise you and thank you for this incredible series, Live Different. We just thank you that you've been speaking through this time and that there's so much more, God, that you want to do in our church in the season to come. In your name we pray. Amen. That is the end of our Live Different series, looking at the Gospel of Luke chapters 9 through 13. Next Sunday in Church Online, we're going to be launching our new Church Online series, which is called Resilient. And we are going to be looking together, church, at the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew 5 through 7, Jesus' teaching, which is so famous, so influential, so incredible, so personal, so practical, Matthew 5 through 7. So that's going to be great as we lead October, November towards Advent, towards the close of our calendar year. It's going to be really good. Can't wait for you to join us next week for the launch of our new series, Resilient. How do we live a Jesus-shaped life? It's going to be great. Thanks for joining this morning, and it's been so great to share with you this morning.
Church. On behalf of the church executive, leadership, and the church body, we'd like to thank you, Jono, for your dedication to serving Willi Church over the past 17 months. When you began your journey with us on the 20th of May, who would have thought that we'd be where we are today, a church online? From the start, your shepherding strength shone through as you made a point to reach out and chat to every member of the Willi Church family and really get to know them. It wasn't long and you were on track and up and running with the preaching plan, which proved to be encouraging and relevant. Helping Hand Cafe was one of the areas of ministry where you focused some of your attention, and I know that the volunteers will definitely miss you and your quirky sense of humour, as will we. Then COVID-19, but that did not diminish you or the ministry team's determination in ensuring the church family still had a place to call home, albeit online or in a connect group. All of this is a true testimony of your love for Christ and for your fellow Christians. Sarah, Reuben and Matilda made their own place in each of our hearts, and what a blessing that has been. Thank you, Sarah, for walking alongside Jono as he journeyed with us in the pastoral role. It has been an absolute pleasure getting to know you. Thank you, Prince family, for this season with us at Willi Church. We are going to miss you. But we know that with God as your guide, you will continue in faith to build his kingdom no matter where he leads you. So I leave you with this. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen. Go with God.
Welcome everyone this morning. Today we have a really important and significant opportunity to bless and thank and acknowledge Jono Prince for his work with us and contribution to our church community since May of 2019 as our associate pastor. And as a ministry team, Tiff, Sarah, and myself, we are really thankful to you, Jono, for your contribution to our ministry team and for the ways that you have blessed each of us and for the ways that you have offered your ministry so readily, so generously and sacrificially. And we are really thankful for the different things that we've learned from you in this season and for the way that you have really offered your gifts of teaching and care and discipleship to our church community in this season. I've been really thankful to work with you and for the different ways that we've been able to really collaborate together. I'm really thankful for that. This morning, I want to kick off our thank you time as a ministry team with some words that our children have put together, Jono, to celebrate you and thank you and offer their words to you of blessing. So from some of our children, first up, from Jude. Thank you for everything you have done for us. And from Eliza, thank you for teaching us. These words are from Oliver. Thank you for everything you have done for us. Thank you for all of the fun stuff you planned ahead of time for our Friday night youth groups and in general. And these are some words from Jasmine. She says, I like that you have kids and that you are hilarious and play fun and funny games at Seeds.
I like that I've got kids too.
Indeed. She says, I'm happy that you chose our church. Good luck at your next job. I hope you find one soon. That's really lovely. And these words are from Bo. And he writes, thank you for doing the youth Zooms and playing with us kids. Thank you for teaching us about God. Thank you for being so funny and for the walks we've been on together. I hope your next job is a good suiting to your character. I'll miss you. And from Ethan, he says to Jono, thank you for all the fun I had with you. You were the best pastor ever. And thank you for the good times at church. Love, Ethan. And from Aliena, Aliena says, thank you so much. Thank you for everything.
Thanks, guys. Kids. I'm sorry, some of the things I've taught you.
Hand over to you, Sarah.
John, I've got some beautiful words from some of the young adults that we have in our church. I've got a note here from Jess. Thank you for all the work that you've done for the youth and young adults, Jono and Sarah. You've been such a blessing for Willi Church. We wish you guys and Reuben and Matilda well for the future as you're guided by God. Also, thanks for the chocolate. And Charlie writes, hey, Jono, thanks for all the laughs, guidance and memories shared at the youth nights. You're a good bloke despite being a city supporter.
And Jono, we've got some thanks from some of from the adults in our church. From Rob at Helping Hand Cafe. Thanks for everything you have done in supporting Helping Hand Cafe and Helping Hand Hampers, Jono. I wish you all the best for the future. From Kate Skeen. Your passion for seeds is contagious. Working with you to make seeds better was more than a pleasure. Our family will definitely miss your family. From Alan. You worked out all right, even though the church took a big risk in employing a Melbourne City fan. Seriously though, you've been a great asset to the church. From Lisa. Jono, we love your humour and passion and will always remember you as the one who almost married us. From Phil. Jono, Sarah, Reuben and Tilly, thank you for being such a vibrant, energetic and slightly crazy part of the Willi Church family. You welcomed us into your hearts and found a place in ours. We pray God's blessing on you all as you continue to faithfully serve him. From Jonathan and Linda and Jamie. Thank you, Jono, for your care, pastoring and leadership, for your companionship and good humour. We wish you the very best for your future ministry. From Libby. Jono, my first introduction to you was you beating away at the drums, maybe more with enthusiasm than talent, but this is what I will miss the most about you. You welcomed me into the congregation and included me in the Helping Hand Hampers, giving me a sense of belonging. For this, I will always be grateful. I never saw the magic trick that you were going to show my son. Perhaps this could be one of your parting performances. I'm looking forward to hearing about your adventures. Please don't lose touch with us. From Jason. I loved doing the crosswords with you, mate. I'll miss that. And Jono, from myself. Jono, we've been blessed by you and your family in many ways, and I have enjoyed working with you. I admire the way you choose to intentionally connect with people, from the people in our congregation, to the electrician who comes to fix a plug socket, to the invisible person that only you notice walking past our building. You generously share your time, humour, and deep trust in God. It's inspiring to me that in the contemporary world of 2020, that you have listened to the voice of God, and despite the cultural norms that would suggest otherwise, that you, as you have, as Jesus' disciples did 2,000 years ago, dropped your net to follow him. God bless you, Jono, Sarah, Reuben, and Tilly.
Thanks, guys.
We hope that you can receive these words of appreciation and thanks, Jono. And Sarah, Sarah Prince, we are honouring you and we're thanking you for the way that you also have impacted us, blessed us, contributed to the life of our church. Even in this season of COVID, we have been enriched, and I know I have been enriched by your presence in our church community and by offering your gift to us. And also Reuben and Matilda, we celebrate you, and you may not even know now, that you have blessed us, but you have, and we're thankful to have been part of some of your earliest years in life as your church family in this this time. And Matilda, you were welcomed into our church as a baby, as a newborn. So we're thankful for you as a family. We're going to be praying for Jono, Sarah, Ruben and Matilda in our prayer lifetime following this church online. So please join with us via Zoom. You'll see the link in the comments here. And we would love to have you join with us to pray God's blessing over the princes for about the first 15 minutes or so of our prayer life today. We're going to be focusing our prayers on the prince family. So please join us for our prayer life today. And that's where we're going to be really praying for this beautiful family as they step into this next season of life and ministry under God with faith that he has good things in store for them, just as church. God has incredible things ahead for us in mission, in ministry, in reaching out to our community, in being the church. It's going to be good. I'm excited for this next season. And I'm excited, Jono, for what God's got ahead for you as you have faithfully followed his call and his voice along with Sarah. God is going to be so good to you and Reuben and Matilda in this time. So church, let's join together affirm together that God has been so good to us in this season, and yet we know he has even better things in store for us as we step into this next season with faith.
Hi, Willi Church. And thank you for those kind words that have been shared for us this morning. We really appreciate them. And this is our chance now to say our farewells to you guys.
We've been so thankful since we've come to Willi Church, how we've been so warmly welcomed into the Willi Church family, particularly as a young, growing family. We're so thankful for all the support and the love that we've received over the past 18 months or so.
And believe it or not, I mean, our little maniac Matilda is even walking now. So it's been a pretty special time for us in the time of our lives. We've really appreciated the opportunities that we've had here in ministry to journey with each one of you guys, learning so many lessons and having such great relationships, things that we will be able to take with us going forward from here.
I think the Willi Church congregation is such a diverse group of Christians, and we have really learned a lot from lots of many different individual people. So that's been a highlight.
And it's just been my absolute privilege, my privilege to be able to minister and to pastor to each of you guys, to build those relationships. And I just want to express my appreciation, my thanks to each one of you who've spent some time with me as we've journeyed together in our faiths. So we're really going to miss each one of you guys as we go from here. But for us from here, as much as we're excited about what's on the horizon for Willi Church, I have a role at Footscray Church of Christ in a consultancy capacity in ministry soon, up until near Christmas. And we're excited to see what happens beyond Christmas as well. So that's just a bit of where we're up to, and we'll be keeping track to see the exciting things that are on your horizon as well.
Oh my.
So for now, in this weird COVID context, in this weird farewell, we say, oh, Reuben, what have you liked?
Zoe. Samuel. Our friends.
Reuben has been thankful for Zoe, Jamie, all his friends, the toys. So from the princes to all of our loved Willi Church family.
Bye.
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 Blow kisses.
Mwah.
Mwah. Mwah. Well done. God bless. Thank you.
your sin. Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Leave behind your regrets and mistakes. Come today, there's a reason to wait. Jesus is calling. Bring your sorrows and trade them for joy. From the ashes a new life is born. Jesus is calling.
Oh, In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace,